Welcome to another edition of Inward Bound for Mindful Living with Mr. Deepa Suryarachchi. Mr. Suryarachchi, I think every single week I hope I don't come to you with problems, but I come to you with different aspects of what I've learned on my own. And the past week, actually, I came across an interesting topic, interesting blog, actually, which is related to a book as well, called The Minimalists. And in it, what they speak about is how you can bring down all of your attachments and everything that you have around you to the bare essentials, the bare minimum, and how to incorporate that into every single aspect of life. And I was curious because it seems to go quite in line with the with what we have been discussing throughout these sessions, throughout these episodes on mindfulness. Could you elaborate on how attachment works with the concept of mindfulness, being aware, and how we can incorporate it?
Okay, thanks for bringing that topic, because I was thinking of discussing letting go today.
Okay,
so I think it's of the same thing from a different point of view. In a very simple sense, when you want to be attached to someone, it means you have to let go of all the others. So to that degree, attachment also means letting go of some things, right? And it's interesting that you talk of these bare essentials, you know. I once had a very interesting experience in a Zen temple in Japan. And we had to stay one day there to experience a full day. And being Japanese Zen temples, they don't have a lot of space. And they said, bring only the bare essentials when you come in. Now, you have to really think, what will I really need for the next one day? It pushes you to think, what do I need? Then I was reading, then you had to think of, okay, will I need all these things? Then you really, you know, because you can carry only one small bag because you don't have space to keep.
Right?
We were a group of about 5-6 people, so we need to be really conscious of that. Now, so then what you do is you let go of some other things. Then if you read stories of people who have climbed mountains, when you are on the ascent to some of these very high peaks like Everest or something like that, then every thing becomes a weight against your survival. And I was reading one, that person was saying, okay, do I need to take my toothbrush? Because anyway, brushing teeth at that height is not a practical thing to do, so you don't take. And he says he even removed the labels from his coats, jackets, because that's also a weight, because we are struggling to survive. And recently I had the privilege of interviewing this Jayanti Kurudumpal, and she confirmed the same thing, because she said, okay, how many chocolates will I take for energy, and how many tablets will I take? Because everything boils down to adding.
And each individual thing, you might think it's small, it just adds up to that.
That happens when you travel.
Yeah. A
lot of people, they can you take this small parcel, somebody else also come with small parcel. And then those all these small parcels put together, it's more than 20 kilos.
Yes.
So how do you let go? And letting go, when you think of letting go, sometimes we think of letting go of good things. You can come to that very, very late. But let's look at how we get attached to things that bother you, things that make you upset, things that depress you. Now that's the problem. I remember this story, you know, those days when they want to catch monkeys. I don't know if I told you this story. What they do apparently is they take a young coconut, right, cut it, and then put some these chickpeas into it. Then monkeys come and they see this. What they will do is they will just put their hand and grab a few of those peas. Now they have tighten the fist, when you pull back, it doesn't come out. So now he is with this big coconut in his hand, and he cannot escape. So people come and catch the monkey. Now all what he has to do is open his...
and he can be free. Yeah.
Free. Now most of the time, we suffer because we hold on to things. And most of these things that we hold on to that makes us unhappy are things that really from the past, and they are things that make us worry. It can be a mistake that has happened. By holding on to this and thinking about it, you can't do anything. Sometimes you cannot completely correct that. But you might be able to do something to correct, if at all. Now, if you learn that I am holding on to it just like this monkey, then you are attaching on to it.
Yeah.
Right. Say somebody has done something to you and you keep thinking about it. What are we doing? We are holding on to the thing that make you unhappy.
And more often than not, that builds up in such a way that it becomes worse. And at the end of the day, that other person might not be affected by it, just like you are being affected by it at that moment.
Precisely. Like if he tells you you are a bad person or something negative to you, say he says you are an idiot. He will tell it only once. But being attached to it,
it keeps echoing in your mind.
Echoing in your mind, recall and replay, recall and replay. Then by end of the day, you have heard this about...
but by yourself. Actually.
By yourself. Right? Yeah. And then you remember every word that he says, you know, 1,000 times. So it's like sometimes, you know, you wake up in the morning with a song...
And then for the rest of the day, you have the same song with you.
Yeah. So don't you realize this is part of our habit? Mm-hmm. So this attachment to things is part of our conditioning. Letting go is the reverse of that. Mm-hmm. And it doesn't happen overnight. Now when you say letting go, there's another side to it. Some people say they throw things away. I don't want this. I hate it.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Now that is not letting go.
That is impulsive, isn't it?
Not only that, then you are still attached to it.
Right, yeah.
For example, say I tell you, Shavin, don't think of an elephant at this moment.
And the only thing that will go through your mind is elephant.
Elephant?
Yes. Yes.
So it's like that. I hate Shavin. The moment I begin to hate Shavin,
yes,
Shavin is in my thoughts all the time. Isn't it?
Yeah.
So then I am not letting go, I am holding on. But some people say, I don't want to see him again. You see, so then can you see this both ends of being holding on an attachment and this repulsion with anger? Both you are holding on.
And I think now we have established exactly that connection point, because I want to bring in attachment and you're talking about almost the complete opposite, but it makes quite a bit of sense as well. And I think we have a lot to delve into, but before we do so, I think we need to take a very quick break. We'll be right back.